So, how do I deal with stressful situations? I've been having some very common recurring conversations with many of my clients leading up to the silly season, leading up to a whole lot of social occasions, social events that can create a whole lot of anxiety and discomfort within. And I'm also getting messages from some of you who are after some tips on how to navigate this time. So, how do I do it? And here's what I've seen. So, first of all, let's peel it back a little bit and understand where the feeling of stress and anxiety comes from in the first place. So, it's so important to understand how things work. If we don't understand how something works, we get confused by it, we get caught up in it, we feel powerless in the face of it, if you like. So let's look at something like stress or anxiety. So those are feelings that we feel within our body. Now, the thing with feelings is they are internally created. So whatever feeling you're sitting in at the moment or at any moment in your life, it is actually coming from the thinking that is going on within your mind. It cannot come from anywhere else. No event, situation, person, place, or thing can put a feeling into you. That is your superpower. You have your own mind. You own your own thinking. It's not who you are, right? It is just universal energy that passes in the front door and can leave out the back door unless you choose to invite it in to stay for a cup of tea. Then it'll hang around. And the thinking that you're focusing on is creating that feeling within. So that's the first thing to understand that. Now, unless you actually step back and take time to observe that in you, you will just be oblivious to it. And you will be pushed around every day, in every moment of every day, by this invisible force that you have no idea that is going on with you. It is so powerful, yet for most people, it is invisible to them. So the first thing is to start noticing, right? Start noticing and connecting the feeling that you've got with the thinking that you've got going on. You start to do that, you'll start to become aware of how much you are creating within you by ruminating, by worrying, by overthinking, by doing all the things that human brains love to do to keep busy, but actually fundamentally takes us out of the present moment. So start observing. The other thing that we all do as human beings is we have a super high tolerance to stress. We let it go for way too long because we're living up here. We're living in this. We are missing out on life. We're disconnected from our life when we're up in here all the time, and we're disconnected from the feeling. So start paying attention and start connecting back to your body, because your body is going to tell you when your thinking is off way before, you get to this point where you can't take it anymore and you react. And you spew it out onto the people you love, and you turn up to event, and you're at, to an event, and your mind is so full of thought that that energy is what you lead with when you come to an event. You drink it, you eat it, you do everything you can to try and relieve the situation when the situation can only be relieved when you allow that thinking to pass, when you step back, when you listen to the wisdom of your body and decide as soon as it starts to feel that your thinking is off, that you're focusing too much in there, that that is the moment that you stop, that you build in some time to let your thinking settle. You don't keep moving forward and going harder. You step back and you let things settle, and then you'll regain your clarity. You might go for a walk. You might ring a friend. You might hug your husband. You might hug your wife. You might hug your kids. You might go and sit in the sun for 5 minutes. You might do some washing. Excuse all my beautiful washing behind me. Reality, right? It doesn't really matter what you do, but it is knowing that You need to listen to your body and feel your body and step back as soon as it starts to tell you that things are going awry, because otherwise it just goes up and up and up and up and up. And then we become this walking ball of tightness that we'll just explode. And usually we explode on the ones that we love the most, right? So it's understanding where the feeling of stress is created. It's observing your body and knowing when it's time to step back. Now, the other thing on that is, yes, stressful events happen, right? I've never ever said, and no one will ever say to you that things don't happen. Life is a contact sport. It is not easy, right? Things will happen to you and to the ones that you love. All these things will happen around you that you cannot control. The only thing you can control is the way that you see it. And there are no rules to the way you see anything. Accepting the way things are is the path to peace. So the question was asked to me, what if I have all these things going on and all these functions and I have no choice, right? Well, in any moment in your life, no matter what it is that you're looking at, you only have two choices. Number one, you change it. Number two, you accept it. Now, if you can't change it, then you need to work out how to accept it. And all that comes from, again, stepping back, stepping out of your thinking, getting back into the present moment and seeing what else occurs to you. Thought is like a buffet. When you let go of the ones that you're focused on and you step back and you allow wisdom to do its job, guess what comes up? Insight, new ideas. And, you know, you are the only one responsible for creating what you want in your life and the feelings that you're sitting in. It's not anybody else's job. It's your job. So if you've got to go somewhere, if you've got to do something, you're the only one that can make it enjoyable. And all that will come is when you change your thought about it and you let go of the ones that are the more habitual ones, that are the negative ones, that you think it's going to be like this and somebody else's fault and why do I have to go and, oh, I have to do this and No. Tip, next tip dealing with this is to take it one day at a time. Notice when your mind wanders off. Notice when you start to overthink, when you start to overanalyze, when you start to worry about all the things that you've got coming up. You cannot deal with a made up future. You cannot deal with something that hasn't yet happened. The past is gone. The future hasn't happened. The only thing you get to deal with is the present moment. And if you see to do that, if you allow your mind, if you detach and step back on the edge of the pool and allow your mind to do that, you're going to have a whole lot more energy to deal with today. What we don't realize is when we're in our head and we're ruminating on the future, worrying about the past, whatever it is, we are out of the present moment, but we're also reducing our bandwidth, our energy, our capacity to deal with what actually happens today. So, yes, you might have 50 things coming up in 2 weeks, but all you can deal with is what is happening today. And when the time comes for you to think about and plan what you need to do, if you need to prepare something, you deal with it and you focus just on that. You don't need to focus on anything else. Excuse the neighbor's dog. So a lot of what happens in people's thinking is habitual thought. Well, all thought is optional. You know, I've spoken about this so much, and this is the basis of all my coaching, because until we see that, we won't see we have a choice, but you do have a choice. So any situation you're in, if you are present, if you know that you are the one responsible for the way you see anything that's in front of you, if you don't like the way you're seeing it, then it's up to you to change it. And all you need to do is let go of the stuff you're believing and wait and see what else comes up. and then you will do your best. So if we look at it in terms of food, right? Yes, there's sugar and crap everywhere around this time. But so what? Does it control you or do you control it? The only way you won't feel like you have control is if you have a whole lot of habitual thought that needs addressing. I and many of my clients can have a buffet of sugar in front of them. They're not interested. It's not part of their world anymore. And Christmas is a time, it's not about food unless you make it about food. It doesn't have to be like that. Just because it's always been like that doesn't mean it always has to be like that. Make it about something else. Make it about family. Make it about presents. Do you know what the best present you can give anybody in your life is? Your presence. Not sitting there on your phone, not sitting there thinking about something else, not wishing you were somewhere else, not blaming someone else for the feeling that you're sitting in. Being there with the people that you're with, that is the best gift you can give anybody in your life, is your presence and your connection and your love unconditionally and without judgment. And just show up as you, because there's nothing greater and there's nothing better. I hope that's helped. Do the best you can. Be you. Bye.